Noah's Ark. Before the great flood, the world had become filled with wicked men, so much so that the Lord decided to destroy the face of the earth. And God said to Noah, "The end of all flesh has come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth." The Lord chose Noah, a man of God, to build an ark in which the righteous would be saved along with some of the animals. Noah preached of conversion and repentance for 120 years, but only 8 people gave their hearts to the Lord and entered the ark. The rain came, and the people sought the safety of higher ground or the ark itself. But the angel of the Lord had closed the door of the ark, and it could not be opened. Probation had closed. It was too late. Death and destruction covered the earth. The thoughts of man were evil continually. God extended an invitation, but it was not accepted. This was a judgment of man. All the fountains of the great deep were broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened, and the rain was on the earth 40 days and 40 nights. So he destroyed all living things which were on the face of the ground. God had saved his people through the flood, but they would spend almost 1 year in the ark, waiting for the floodwaters to recede and new life to begin. Noah and his family were anxious to leave the ark. Finally, Noah knew it was safe to leave. He offered a sacrifice to the Lord, and the Lord placed a bow of promise in the sky that he would never again destroy the earth with a flood. The Bible tells us where the ark of Noah came to rest. The ark rested upon the mountains of Ararat. But what is Ararat? The name Ararat, as it appears in the Bible, is the Hebrew equivalent of Urartu, ancient country of Southwest Asia mentioned in Assyrian sources from the early 13th century BC. This area included parts of eastern Turkey, Armenia, and Iran. Moses was not speaking of a specific mountain when writing Genesis. He was speaking of a country, Urartu. So the Bible was saying the ark came to rest in the mountains of the country of Urartu. In eastern Turkey, across the valley from Mount Ararat, is the site we will be visiting. This area was first photographed in an aerial survey conducted in 1959 by Francis Gary Powers. Later, Turkish Lieutenant Duripinar spotted the boat-shaped object in these photographs. So in 1960, a group from the United States journeyed to the site, but they prematurely concluded it was just a natural formation. That same year, Life magazine featured photos of the site. Is there a historical record from ancient civilizations of Noah's Ark existing? Berosus the Chaldean wrote, "It is said there is still some part of the ship in Armenia, at the mountain of the Chordians, and some people carry off pieces of the bitumen, which they take away, and use chiefly as amulets for the averting of mischiefs." Today, we can look at a map of Turkey and see this site listed as Nuhun Cimisi, or Noah's Big Boat. Making the trip to the site, we landed next to the very large Lake Van, which once hosted the ancient capital of Urartu named Tushba, located along its shore. Heading out through the countryside, we see an extinct volcano. Crossing a mountain, we soon see our first glimpse of the famous Mount Ararat in the distance. In the shadows of Ararat is the city of Dobayazit that we pass through, heading toward the Noah's Ark site. Mount Ararat is a beautiful mountain, complete with a rich history of mountain climbers searching for the Ark, but without success. Across the valley, we stop and see the government-erected road sign, Nuhun Cimisi, 5 kilometers up the mountain. On Ron Wyatt's first trip to the region in 1977, he didn't know where to begin searching, and he only had 3 days in the area. So he and his teenage sons prayed that their taxi would stall in areas where they needed to search. That day, God stalled their taxi in 3 different locations, and here is our first taxi stop. High on the mountain is the resting place of Noah's ship. The name of this mountain is translated as Doomsday Mountain, named so for the deadly event of the flood. As we drive up the mountain, we can see Lesser Ararat and Greater Ararat across the valley. Both are post-flood volcanic mountains that were not even here during the flood, and they would be the last place one should search for the Ark. We finally made it to the Ark. Looking at it from the stern, or rear, one can see the boat-shaped outline of the Ark. It has a rounded stern and a pointed bow or front. The symmetrical shape indicates that it is a man-made structure. Ron Wyatt made 24 trips out here to conduct tests and do research at this boat-shaped formation. Photos taken at different times of the year have brought out different features of the boat. There was so much convincing evidence uncovered at the site that the Turkish government declared this area to be Noah's Ark National Park. And yet today, the world is unaware of this amazing discovery.